Everyone, I hope you all are doing well. My name is Dev and welcome back in Pattern Craft. So guys, today I'm going to create a Christmas outfit. For that, I had saved some reference images which I'm going to follow, okay, only for the references. And the avatar I'm going to use is from the Daz. I'm not using the default Clo avatars, so I had saved the Daz avatar which we will going to use in the Clo. Okay, so let's get start this video. And before starting, if you didn't subscribe my channel, please subscribe it, and you can also follow us on Instagram, okay, where we are uploading all the projects, all the work. So let's get start this video. So guys, in this outfit we will going to create the sweatshirt, okay, and a skirt, okay. So let's get start with the sweatshirt. Let me import the avatar which we had exported from the Daz 3D. So I had exported the obj file. Import. Let me turn off the textures of the avatar. Okay, so let's start. So this is the avatar we will going to use, and here we will start the patterns. Okay, I will simply start with creating a basic block. The sweatshirt will be oversized sweatshirt we will going to create, and in the texturing part we will add some patches, okay. In this new update of the Clo, they had increased the sensitivity of the mouse scroll button in the 2D window. It's not working properly. No problem. Okay, so let's duplicate it. Okay, this will be the black back. Okay, so this will be the front and back. Let me also create the rib part. Okay, unfold it symmetrically, duplicate. Okay. Now we will create the sleeves. So let's arrange all the pattern pieces. So now we'll stitch all the parts. So let's simulate it. We will also create the cuff. Okay. Let's stitch this part also. Okay. Duplicate. Now we will create the neckband. So our neck length is 8 inches and half, so we will create a block of 6 inches, 1 inches neck width. Let me change the grain line so we can achieve a proper stretch. Okay. So this is the neck we have created. So basic garment we had created. Now we will create the skirt, its bottom part. Okay, so again we will switch to the 2D window so we can create all the pattern pieces. Import symmetrically. So right now it's, so let me create the pattern with this pattern. Instead of this, we can create an ellipse.
And inside ellipse, we will create a, again internal ellipse. Its radius will be 5 inches. Okay, so let me add it in the center. Okay, let's cut this one. Okay, let me remove this part. So create one more copy of this. Okay, this is for the back. This is for the back. Okay. So again, let me switch to the 3D view. This is for the back. Okay. And this is for the front. And let me put it on the top. Instead of doing this, we will simply rotate it from here. Okay. So let's stitch it. This will be the front and this will be the back. Okay. So let me do converting the layer, so we will make it -1. Okay, so before this, let me freeze it, and now we can simulate it. It. Okay, so this one we have done. Now what we will do, we will also create one more layer. So we can create a knitted mesh fabric we can use on that layer. Okay, so here we have done. Let me also make it a little tight. So 8 in the right. Done. So let me remove the layers first. So this is the style we had created, and one more layer we will create on it. Over, let me remove the link and also remove the stitches. Let me freeze it. Okay, so there are two layers, and let me change the fabric of this layer. Let me make it a little bit. This will be the minus one. This will be the one. This will be the two. Okay. Let me change the fabric again. For these are going to be the best. And also remove the layers and the face. So now we will just decrease the opacity right now, so we can, so the internal fabric will be visible for us. Okay. And also increase the thickness of this waistband. So basic style we had created right now. Now what we will do, we will reduce the particle distance and see. Before that, let me also reduce the thickness. Sorry, thickness of these layers. And these are the double sided. Okay. Now let me reduce the particle distance to 12.
Now what we will do, first I will make some changes in the structure. I had decided to make it for the Christmas, so we add some textures. So I had already saved some of the textures. Let me add. I'm just going to use them as a reference. I'm not going to use them properly totally. What I will do, let me use it. Okay. So first I think we can start with the sleeves. Basically what here I will do, I will just use them as a reference and I will create these prints on the sleeve. Okay. Also okay, so let me switch to the movie window. So what we will do, we will create all the pattern pieces for the lights. So let me first I will going to arrange all the UV maps. Okay, so I am going to switch to the UV editor. Here I will arrange all the UV maps. First let me arrange them by default. Okay, so this is also a new update in the Clo. So they had updated the UV editor. So now they had added a feature to, so we can arrange all the UV maps not in a single block. Okay, so let's try it how it will work. Let me check. Okay, let's see. I think still we didn't got that update which I'm thinking. So still it's only arranging all the UV maps in a single block. They didn't add a feature through we can specify in how many blocks we need to arrange all the UV maps. No problem. So let's try this one and we will arrange everything manually. Okay. So first let me take out guys. We will going to create all the textures and the coloring. Okay, so first I will try to use the default fabric if we find something accurate. And before adding that fabric, I also want to add a logo in the front. I want to add an embroidery logo. For that we will create it using a vector file, so which I had already saved. So let me create the embroidery file. For creating the embroidery effect, for the embroidery effect we will going to use the Adobe Substance Sampler. Okay, so let me switch. Okay, so let's create new file. Okay, so we will going to create embroidery effect. For that we need to import our vector file. Okay, so I had already removed the background of this slide, so let me move it. Okay, so now what we will do, we are going to add a layer of
with this we will create the embroidery effect. Properties, Okay, so we had almost done everything. Okay, now let me also increase the table before starting. Okay, now we will export the file. Okay. Okay, so let's export the file. Now I'm going to import that file in the Clo. Let me export the file again. Delete this one. It is also a file. Okay, so let me scale down. So this is complete, and let me also reduce the particle distance of these panel. Okay, this one is done. So let me try with some other fabrics we have. Let's try with this fabric.
Okay.
Okay, first let me change the fabric. Okay, and what we will do, we will remove this print. This one will do. So we will reduce the particle distance of these parts. We will make it 7. And we will change the fabric properties, make them fur, and we will add a and also change the color to be orange. So let's first check the render view how it looks, and if any changes are required, we will make the changes. Add the displacement value.
Okay, this one will work.
Okay, so we will going to use this fabric. Okay. And for the these bulbs, maybe we can try terry coat fabric. Let's see the render how it looks. Then we can decide. Yes, this can we can this one we can use. Okay, so for the same setting you use for the other color variations. Okay, so fur and tail coat. For the cloth, and maybe we need to choose the fabric, so it will be okay. So all we have done. Now what we will do? We will make some changes in the hat. Okay, so we will decide. And before that, first we will make changes in the skirt. Okay, so our sweatshirt fabric is confirmed, and now we will change skirt fabric. For this we are going to use satin, and in top we will going to use some lace fabric. Which have some satin and color will be and for a cap, we are going to use a velvet fabric with red color. This will be for with record. So let's see how it looks in the render view, and there are more fabrics available. We can try if we didn't like any one of them. Let's add this one also, so we can try this. Using stitch tool, okay. Thank you.
Okay, so let's save it. So I hope guys you like this video, and if you like this video, you can subscribe to our channel. You can also follow us on our Instagram, where we are uploading our all the styles and all our work. So thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.